Welcome to the Hotend Replacement Guide for Pro2 Systems. This guide will assist you in all the necessary steps for removing, replacing, and aligning the hotends in your Pro2 system. Removal. To begin, use the touchscreen to lower the build plate. Open the Utilities tab and use the blue downward arrow to lower the plate to a comfortable working height, approximately 5 to 12 inches. Unload the filament completely. For more details on how to unload filament, visit our Filament Basics guide. From the home screen, select the nozzle temperature and set it to 0 to begin cooling. To speed up the cooling process, you may also enable the cooling fans. To do this, open the Tune tab and set the fan speed to 100%. Once the hot end has reached an ambient temperature, disable the cooling fans and power off your printer. Use your 2.5mm hex wrench to remove the two securing screws from the cooling fan for both the left and the right sides. These screws are located closest to the front of the machine. Set the screws aside and let the fan hang out of the way. Next, loosen the four set screws located inside the heating block. These do not need to be removed, but only broken free to allow for an easy release once the hot end has been removed. Use your 2.5mm hex wrench to loosen the hot end securing screw. This will allow you to remove the hot end from the securing collar. Continue to loosen the four set screws to release the wiring. Once loosened, slide the hot end off the wiring to completely release it from the machine. Installation and alignment. Inspect your replacement hot end and verify that the heat sink lies flush with the base of the large cylinder. If adjustments are needed, refer back to the nozzle replacement guide. Position the hot end so that the screws are facing outwards. Insert the wiring into the heater block with the red wire into the bottom hole and silver wire into the upper hole. Ensure the wires are inserted completely, then secure them by tightening the four set screws with your hex wrench. Install your hot end by inserting it into the fixing collar. Make sure it is inserted all the way up and secure it with its screw. Rotate the Z thumb screw counterclockwise one full rotation to prepare for alignment. Power on your unit. From the home screen on the touchscreen, select the Z axis home icon to home your Z axis. Set the temperature for both nozzles to 180 and allow it to reach temperature. Once the temperature is achieved, enable the left nozzle by selecting the corresponding nozzle icon and selecting the downward arrow. Next, use your feeler gauge to adjust the Z offset distance to the left nozzle. When properly calibrated, the nozzle should provide friction without requiring excessive force. To adjust the distance, rotate the thumb screw outwards to bring the bed closer, and rotate the thumb screw inwards to move the bed further away. Each adjustment should be made incrementally, and the printer will need to be homed between each adjustment. For more information about Z offset adjustments, reference the Z offset video guide on this channel. Once the desired height is achieved, we will adjust the right nozzle in respect to the current bed position. Open the Utilities tab and enable the right nozzle. Set the temperature for both nozzles to 0 and allow them to cool completely. Once the hot ends have been cooled completely, insert the feeler gauge underneath the right nozzle and loosen the securing screw for the hot end. Allow gravity to rest the nozzle onto the feeler gauge, then tighten the screw to secure this position. Now that both nozzles are properly calibrated, lower the bed position to a comfortable working height and reinstall the cooling fans.